wanna let you know the key. So, Shelly Shaw, go let you know it's real.
It's the reality show.
And you ain't even gotta turn your TV on.
It's the reality show. It's the reality show.
It's the reality show.
Welcome to the reality show. It's your boy, Mr. Unique Akeem, a.k.a. The Prince Nasir. And I'm here kicking it once again on acceleratedradio.net. And I'm hanging out with my main homegirl and partner in crime, Miss Rosemary Lopez.
Hola, hola.
And I'm joined again by the beautiful, lovely, talented, incredibly bodacious, Miss Cynthia Garcia.
Thank you. Hey, hey.
Yes, yes. And of course, we can't forget about the man that's keeping the reality show all the way live. On come to you live on the ones and twos, Mr. DJ Spin. Yeah. He over there getting his headphones and all that together. We want to first of all thank all our listeners out there for faithfully tuning into this broadcast every Monday night at 9 o'clock p.m. Pacific time. We also want to thank our vendors out there for believing in our vision and our ideas. Cynthia, how you doing today?
Good.
I'm glad you?
You
could join us. I'm wonderful, actually. I'm very wonderful.
I got my rest.
So. I see you did. You had a long weekend.
I did.
A long week, actually, because you went on vacation and
I
all that, huh?
Mexico, and yeah, it was fun.
Damn, okay.
I'm back, though.
That's good stuff,
man.
I know. We miss you, too, yo.
I know. We
still waiting on T to get back here, too, man. She down south.
She's
kicking it hard.
She's in tonight.
Is she in tonight?
But, I mean, she'll be here.
She'll be here, okay.
She'll fly in tonight, but she won't be able to make it.
We're looking forward to hearing all the crazy stories.
I know.
Yeah, so as you people out there already know, I know y'all been listening to the show, so I ain't tripping. Today's topic of discussion again is how to talk to women, part two.
Yes,
except for today is all about the women. It's about the panel, you know what I'm saying? We're going to figure out from the horse's mouth how to talk to women, you know what I'm saying? So y'all got to be faithful, y'all got to be truthful, and kick the actual factual and let us know what it really is. Yes. All right, so we're gonna skip the bitters and all that good stuff. We're gonna go right into the topic, okay? Because
lots of cover.
Yeah, straight off the cuffs. So before we go into the cuffs, I think we need to introduce the guests. I'm getting ahead of myself.
I think that's a good idea.
Yeah.
And wait, why does my mic keep going out? Bankhead's over there hating.
Bankhead is like he's a toy right now in the toy store. He's kicking it. He's like having a
lot.
It's the topic that's got everybody shook up, man. I'm telling you. It's only three men in the studio right now. We're surrounded by nothing but beautiful women. So it's about to be crazy.
Lucky you.
Okay, so first up to bat, people, it is my honor and privilege to announce this young lady. She's very talented. All of you people out there may not or may know who she is, but she's very talented. She's an artist, you know what I'm saying? She's doing her fashion thing, you know what I'm saying, and all that good stuff. And I'm sure y'all love her music just as I do. Ladies and gentlemen of the reality show, help me in welcoming Miss Natasha Smith from season 3. Nastasia Smith from season 3, Love & Hip Hop. I butcher everybody's
it's
name.
It's okay. He does this to everybody.
It's what I do.
No, it's okay. A lot of people, you know what I mean, like, can't pronounce my name for shit. That's why.
It's a dope name, too.
Everybody calls me Nas, so you
could
just...
That's me, Nas. Nasir. Yeah. But that's a dope name.
Thank you.
For real. That's very pretty. What does it mean, by the way?
It means princess, actually.
Okay.
It's Russian. A lot of people are like, are you Russian? I'm like, do I look Russian?
That's dope. Yes. And also, we have in the studio today, I'm very impressed with this young lady's music, man. She's a singer-songwriter. She's been doing some really dope things lately, man. She got some music coming out. I checked out a video. Dopeness. Times 100,000. Ladies and gentlemen, help me in welcoming Miss Rain Basu. I want to make sure I got your name right, because I was looking at the last name before you came, and I'm like talking to Rosemary, like, yo, I can't understand. Like, is
I'm
it,
like,
she
it's
Spanish?
French,
what is
French.
She?
It's gravy.
It's
Don't
French.
Even
talk
about it.
French.
French. So it's Rain Basu. Rain is an anagram for my real name.
Okay.
I keep it secret because I'm a teacher.
Okay.
I'm not singing, and I don't want my kids to find me.
Right.
And then bisou means kiss, but it means kiss in French because early on in my in my singing career, I was working with a French producer, and he gave me some advice. He's like, I want you to get in the studio and I want you to give me that feeling. I want you to sing to me the way that you feel a French kiss feels.
Oh, wow. Okay. Stuck. Okay.
So I was like, all right, I'm gonna call myself Rain Bisou.
How a French kiss feels.
Yeah. So that's what I focus on. Like, I like for, you know, like my singing to be awakening, to be seductive, to be soulful.
And it's all that. It's all that. Yeah. And you about to tell us how a dude can approach you and actually get to feel what that real French kiss feels like.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That's what we're about to get into. Okay. So, Miss Rosemary, please give us a catch word of the day.
Catch word of the day is a womanopoly.
Yes.
Definition of that is a woman who knows what she wants and is very good at manipulating men into getting what she wants from them.
Yes.
Womanopoly.
Monopoly.
Yeah. That's like the Monopoly game, except women monopolizing the game of men. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I can't say I made that up.
Womanopolizers.
Yeah. All right, so basically, let's get into the topic. Okay, so there's three types of females out there, for all y'all don't know, okay? There is the stigma female, beta woman, and then there is the alpha woman, okay? The alpha woman, of course, is the woman most of society know about. This is the independent woman, the woman that don't need a man. She making the money. She making the bread. She thinks like a dude. You know what I'm saying? She's out there getting it. However, you know what I'm saying? Like, she don't care. She's running dudes. Womanopoly, right? Beta woman is the woman that basically she likes having her own, but don't mind sharing her own with a man. You know what I'm saying? She don't mind being submissive, but at the same time being authority. You know what I'm saying? Like, or authoritarian. When she has to. You know what I'm saying? But for the most part, it's almost like she wants to be in a relationship and thrives to be in a relationship and don't mind giving people a chance to be in one. That's the beta woman. You know what I'm saying? She just wants to be honest.
She would be like a passive aggressive. Her personality would be like a
passive aggressive. Right. Exactly. Okay. And then you got the Sigma woman. The Sigma woman is the solo woman that's just like, you know what? I ain't studying these dudes. I'm going to do me. And if a dude come along, cool. If not, whatever. She ain't tripping. She's smart. She's intelligent. She's more on the submissive side, but at the same time, she does what's necessary. In other words, she knows her place. So these are three categories of women. So when we approach women, we are approaching either one or three of these types of females. That's the issue men out here got to understand. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I got Fly King Guy in the studio. He ain't saying nothing right now because he coming in later. But I'm going to make sure he back me up on this, all right? All right, give me a like a sign or something, right, Fly King? We good? Right, okay, we good. Yeah. He going to click some rounds for y'all later. So basically, question to the panel. Okay. At what point? Well, let me say this, because usually females, this is just my analogy of how y'all think. Like, y'all usually, when a dude approach y'all in either one or two different spaces in your life, okay? Either you're in a space where you're looking for a relationship and you just got out of one, or you're in a relationship, or you're in a situation where you're not looking for a dude, but you're looking for like a kind of like a FWB, or you're in a situation where you just ain't trying to deal with dudes, you hate dudes, you on your high horse, F them, I'm good, waiting to excel, I'm done. So my question is, at what point in y'all life do y'all know what type of man fits each one of these categories? In other words, at what point in your mind in your life do y'all actually realize the type of dude for you? Like, the type of dude that approach you? Because my philosophy is, like, if a dude approach a woman, it's like the woman already knows if it's a yes or no. Right. If I'm going to accept or I'm going to decline. Right. They already know because they know they type. Exactly. They know, okay, this dude's clearly not my type. No. Right. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Period. Right. Done. Yeah. But, you know, that ain't going to stop a dude from trying. So what point in your life y'all actually figure it out? Because there's also a point in your life where y'all just taking the applications, like, whatever.
I don't know what I like, I'm just trying everything.
I know exactly
what I want, but I know, like, to feed out, like, the bullshit, you get what I'm saying? Like,
what's bullshit to you?
The games. Like, I just, if you can't be honest with me, then I can't. It's like, if I start seeing that you're lying off rip off of the dumbest stuff, it's just not gonna work.
But say a dude's spitting game at you, right? Mm-hmm. You know, he's like, you know, he's making fun of your name. Like, he may come at you with a line like, oh, Nastasia, okay, well.
Why are you trying to make fun of my
I'm
name?
Just saying, he might say something sly like, oh, like, you related. He might say something sly like, oh,
yeah,
you related
to.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like, you related. I know you heard that. Like, you related to Nas. Can I call you Nas? You know what I'm saying? Like,
right.
I know they done said some crazy. You know what I'm saying?
They'll say whatever.
Nastasia, is that sure for Nas? Or is that Fantasia?
Oh, God.
You know what I'm saying?
Like what you said, the Natasha thing?
Yeah. No, just. And so, like, what's your response to that? You know, when a dude come at you?
I like to laugh, like, you know what I'm saying? So if you hit me with the jokes first, you might can stay around for a little
bit. So you're approachable.
Longer. Yes, I am. I'm very nice. I might not look like so you people probably think that I'm like,
so you're in a beta category. You're a beta woman.
Yeah, but I'm like, I'm really nice. Like, you could just talk to me, you get what I'm saying? But now if you hit me with, like, the corny shit, like, just be yourself. Like, don't do too much.
And yeah.
Like,
don't offend you.
Right.
And nothing like that. I respect that. Yeah. She's approachable. That's what's
I'm
up.
I'm very approachable.
Okay, Miss Rain. Well, I mean, when do you find out when you know the type of dude that you be trying to, you know, accept the application from? Because you're an artist and all that, so you got to figure out what his intent is. If he with me for the money and the fame, or is he with me because he actually dig me? You know what I'm saying?
It's the vibe. It just doesn't lie. Like, a dude is going to emit something. It's the way he feels to you. Like, if you get a weird-ass vibe from him, you already know, and you just got to trust your gut. Like, it's that simple.
So, like, he's like 350 pounds and he's like, hey, what's up? You holler?
No, because okay. I obviously have
so
my own, like, primordial attraction towards men.
You're not you superficial? Are.
But for me, like, it's the gift of gab. If you really know how to talk to a woman, like, you're going to interest me because I'm a sapiosexual. Like, I'm a bibliophile. Like, I like to fucking read. I'm an autodidact. Like, I like to learn shit. If you can't fucking school me and I'm going to be running circles all over you, you're not going to interest me.
Oh,
I'm
going
to move on to the next one. You know what?
I think all our listeners, they don't like that.
You know, a woman's largest sexual organ isn't her fucking clitoris, because that shit's small as fuck. It's not her titties, it's her fucking mind.
Thank you. High five on that shit.
Stimulate the mind. Hey. You got it all.
Stimulate the mind. Yes. Sapiosexual.
Yeah.
For all those that don't know, that is mental psychological stimulation. This is when a woman gets off on knowledge. Right. Okay, so Miss Cynthia Garcia. Yeah, because you're just throwing big words out there. You know what I'm saying? Like,
I think with age and experience, you have that discernment to know the difference between this guy's just spitting some game and bullshit as opposed to him being real.
Exactly.
But so I mean, personally, that's why me personally, I think now I have a better idea about it than I did
from day. Okay, I got you.
You know what I mean?
From the experience.
Exactly.
It was just like, oh, you want to chill? You think I'm cute? You're cute, whatever. But now it's just like, okay, what are we gonna talk about?
Yes.
Do you even care if I like what I did today, how my day went? If I ate today, like, what my goals are.
Yeah, you start to weed things out. Yeah, like, okay, like, he's not paying attention, or he hasn't asked me this yet, or he's not interested. Right.
Okay, so what was just, because some dudes had this issue where they can't even get to, like, the second base. Like, they can't, when I say second base, I ain't talking about the bedroom. I'm talking about, like, just, okay, how you doing, conversation off. It's not even that. Y'all like, no, I'm good. Yes, all short answers. Like, no, I mean, how do they get past that point?
It's all first impression.
It's the
you
presentation.
You get one chance.
Okay.
That's it.
So they gotta make you laugh or something. Say something funny, witty.
But for
okay.
every girl's different, you know. Some girls, if he's too goofy, then it's not her. You know, it's not what she's interested in. But maybe to the next girl, she's like, oh, I love that, you know. Right. And she'll give him a chance.
Some women like the disrespect though, because I heard females
disrespect
say,
in what way?
Like, I heard females say, I want a guy to be like, if a guy be like, hey bitch, they be like, oh my god, that is so sexy. No. He called me a bitch. Did you hear what he just said? Hey bitch, that shit turned me on. Some women are weird like that.
That
they
sounds
be like
some lack of
self. I'm telling you, yo.
Right.
I'm telling you. That women are weird like that. I'm telling you.
So.
They like all type of stuff. They out there.
Don't get me wrong. Don't get me wrong. I don't really like overly nice.
Get into the mic.
I'm trying to fix my personal. I don't like overly nice, like, guys. Don't get me wrong. Like, you have to, like, talk shit to me. Like, you get what I'm saying? Not, like, saying, bitch, I'm gonna fuck you up or anything. Excuse my language, but like
damn, bitch, what's wrong with your hair?
But you have to have some type of ball.
Yeah, like, don't let me just walk all over you.
You gotta have a backbone,
right?
I think it's different.
But I like a mixture of both.
But like initially though, like before you know him, though, how would you like him to approach you?
Just be him, like, you get what I'm saying. Like, show your interest in what you're doing.
And I think all them they talking shit. I think it's bullshit.
No, it's not. If I'm physically like interested, like if I like the way you
you're
look, like yeah,
him.
If I'm attracted to you, then it's like okay, that's easier. You get what I'm saying? And then like show me you, like.
How can that be true when you got like people that's like 350 pounds and this dude can make her laugh and now she's with it?
Nah. What do you mean?
Dude don't have to be attractive.
No, because some people he probably hit her with the, you know, the little finesse. I don't know, like, it's a lot of lines out there.
But for
like,
you gotta, it has to be something.
It has to be something, because, like, I can't just go on dates. Like, I went on a date the other day, and I tried it. Like, I really tried to, like, do this little date thing, like, meet somebody, or, like, this guy, he hit me up. slid in my DMs. You know what I mean? It was like, okay, like, let's go to the movies or whatever. Like, never met
everybody's
him before.
DM. What's up with that, man? That's whacked. Hit me on my DM. Yeah. I mean, what? I mean, how many times you online? I mean, come on.
No, yeah. So, like, we went to the movies, and he was very nice. Don't get me wrong. We really didn't have nothing to really talk about. Like, we were in the Uber, and I'm like, talk to me, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't really know you. You don't really know me. Like, this is our time. We're about to go in the movies. We're not going to have a full conversation in the movies.
And the movie's actually on the first date is a bad idea. Yeah. 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 If he's saying let's go to the movies and he's not,
get to know somebody.
Red flag. Date's over.
So Ray, go ahead. I'm sorry.
Yeah, and then, like, he hit me up afterwards, and he's like, yo, like, did I do something wrong? And I feel bad, because I'm like, you didn't do anything wrong, because, like, you're really nice, but you're just not
interested. He didn't get your interest.
And it's just, like, with me, I feel like I have to have, like, a good, like, 10-15 minutes with you before we go somewhere or dates, so I know if I like you or if there's going to be interest.
It's not a general conversation.
Yeah, because, like, if I know that in 10-15 minutes that this is not going to go anywhere, I'm like, okay, I'm not going to sit in dinner and with drinks, and, like, I'm going to be bored, and you're going to see it on my face. And then, like, it's just...
You can't hide it.
Yeah, I can't.
So, Rain, you look like the woman that kind of, like, I mean, quote me if I'm wrong. I could be wrong, but you seem like the romantic type. Like, you want to be wooed and all that ish.
Like, you want to be friends.
It seemed like, tell me if I'm wrong or not. You seem like the type of woman that a dude approach you like some old school type, gentleman type, you know what I'm saying? And he's talking to you with some sense, like, excuse me, miss, let's go. Because you know what I'm saying? You seem like that. I don't know. I could be wrong.
Yeah, I'm into that Southern Belle Scarlett O'Hara shit.
Yeah, yeah.
I dig it.
Yeah, that's why I think you got that whole energy, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you seem like you really...
I do, but at the same time, I enjoy practicality, and, I mean...
That's another big word we don't make.
She's smart.
If you want to kick it, like, I'm down to, like, go to the library and, like, kick it, you know?
The library?
Yeah.
Are you serious?
Like, who go to the library, or, like, go hiking, or, like,
You have dates at a library? You've done that before?
Yeah, or you go to a coffee shop to talk.
Oh, coffee shop. Okay,
like,
that makes sense.
Because I'm into dudes but library, that books know sound their boring shit, to dudes. You feel me? Like, I like dudes that, like, are actually interested in developing themselves. Right. Like, not just about stacking your paper, because anybody can fucking do that shit. Like, it's
that
anybody
is true.
Could be a fucking hustler as long as they know enough math to get by. Like, somebody that's really interested in
you need
in
to leave planet Earth,
because
you ain't going to find that.
Says who?
I'm just playing. I don't know.
No,
it's out here.
Like, if you really think about it, what you attract who you are.
That's true. That's very true.
I would think a lot of men are intimidated by her, maybe.
I think
100%. 100%.
Cynthia, I think that men would look at her as a challenge.
Okay, some men, yes, who are up for it, and then others who are not.
Because a gentleman's going to look at her as a challenge.
Back and be like, you know what,
they're going to look at her as a
challenge.
Yeah, exactly. They'll be like, okay, she's definitely a challenge. I can't come in here like, yo, baby, what's up? Where you get that smile from? Cherry lipstick, what's up? Can I try some of your lip? You know what I'm saying?
Hey, yo, cherry lipstick.
I'm not gonna be with it. Like, I'll just roast you.
Hey, yo,
if you're
black beanie. Hey, yo, black beanie, cherry lip.
Hey, yo, yo, yo.
I can't. I'm just gonna look at him like, even your conditioning has been conditioned.
But it's not fault that it's not really their fault that they don't know proper grammar. I mean, the influencers are like Lil Wayne and rap music.
Well, that's why I don't fuck with those types.
Right. You speak your mind. You I mean, we got to bleep. How many bleeps we got to do in the show, yo? Like, bleep. Nah, it's cool. But luckily, it's internet. But she's like, beep, motherfucker. I'm like, damn, shit. Okay, so. No, I don't even go for that motherfucker. I'm like, damn.
I'm sorry.
You passionate, though.
You know, it's about being eloquent and knowing how to cuss.
Another big word.
And, you know,
You know, you're mixing the Ebonics with the big words and then the cuss words. It's kind of throwing everybody off. So please stay in one lane. Okay, so. You're going to be cussing. All right, so, so what we're going to do is get into some music right now. Your music dope, by the way, yo.
Thank you.
I mean, I was listening. I was talking to Rosemary before the show. I was listening to her. Like, yo, she sounded like a sister. Like, she's, like, blowing.
She could
really
sing.
She could really sing, like, for real. Yeah, so what you got coming up? What you got new projects coming up?
I got two albums that I'm working on.
Two albums, okay.
Yeah.
Look at
you. I got one, it's called Lucidity, and it's a continuation of Lucid Dreams, which is my debut EP.
That's what's up.
My debut EP, Lucid Dreams, is a 90s reminiscent hip-hop project, very influenced by Mariah Carey, by SWV, by Aaliyah, by Selena, and we mixed it in with a little bit of hip-hop stuff, like The Far Side, stuff like, you know, like... like J Dilla beats and like a Camp Low. Okay. So we wanted something that was gonna be for like the urban underground, for like the cult following, for the Erykah Badu followers. You know what I mean? And then these next two albums that I'm doing, Lucidity is more like.
You doing them at the same time?
Yeah.
What, you trying to be like Prince or something?
Yeah, why not?
Like five albums a week.
Yeah, I'm a little bit ambitious, yeah, but I take my time. You
That's
know,
what's
like
up.
I take my
so
time.
So you go hit them with a double whammy, like left, right, bam, bam.
I don't know yet. I might do a double album. I might release one before I release the other one. What I really want to do is, right now I'm focusing more on my album, which is a live album, mm-hmm, called The Word Love. Like, okay. I'm a really big fan of like Etta James and Amy Winehouse and funk music.
I love Amy Winehouse. She's the ish.
Exactly. And yeah, so I'm doing a live album, horn sections and keys, like, okay, Alicia Keys, and just, okay, really like blatant topics about love and feminism and sex and weed.
That's what's
and,
up.
You know, just keeping it really open.
All the good stuff.
Yeah. That's dope. That's dope.
And then, right, you know, Lucidity is more like, what would I compare it to? Like Alina Baraz meets Trap Soul. Like,
dope,
something just really revolutionary and seductive and real and but at the same time, really spiritual. Like, I think some of our music right now is just lacking attention to the mind and attention to the spirit.
You like, it's like you, right now you're talking about like a filet mignon steak, and it's like making me hungry. That's your music right now. Doing that. So I want to hear up and hear what you got to do, because you like, I'm like, my ears is like watering. So DJ Smooth, I mean DJ Spin, please spin that ish, please. I'm like, call him DJ Smooth. And
I'ma tell you what your man can't say. If he ain't want me, why he all in my face? I'ma tell you what your man won't do. Oh, you his girl? Call me Mrs. Me Too, huh? Call me Mrs. Me Too. Call me Mrs. Me Too, huh? Call me Mrs. You his girl? Call me Mrs. Me Too. It goes down in the DM. Girl, you should be in my DM. I know you checking on my timeline. Stop calling, girl, it's my time. Real with it, he know how to deal with it. People got things back when I'm still with it. He said, Snapchat me that. Not for nothing, but I'm on to the next. I'ma tell you what your man can't say. If he ain't want me, why he all in my face? I'ma tell you what your man won't do. Oh, you this girl, call me Mrs. Me Too, huh? Call me Mrs. Me Too. Call me Mrs. Me Too, huh? This is me too. Oh, you need to call me Mrs. Me Too. She's steady hating. They're talking on the top of conversation. I'm getting money while you're steady waiting. I think I'm here to take a chance. You and everything. Them never brought up my feet. These dull and they feelings. My money stacked in the ceiling. I'm in them hills and they killing. These playing with feelings. Ha. I'ma tell you what your man can't say. If he ain't want me, why he all in my face? I'ma tell you what your man won't do. Oh, you his girl? Call me Mrs. Me Too, huh? Call me Mrs. Me Too. Call me Mrs. Me Too, huh? Call me Mrs. Me Too. Oh, you his girl? Call me Mrs. Me Too.
Yes, yes, yes. Okay, hey. April Fools. Ha, ha, ha. Yo, that was actually Nastasia, yo.
That was actually
that
was
yeah,
the,
yeah.
That was the just kidding.
Yeah, I was just kidding. But it's April, right? Aren't we still in April?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So that was
April Fools?
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, yeah, right. So that's what we did for y'all. Ha,
you guys
joke,
just
joke.
Finished, you guys just finished hearing the sounds of Miss Nastasia, right?
Yes.
Right, Nastasia.
Nastasia.
So we're working on getting Miss Rain's Rain song.
Yeah, she's gonna be back in the next segment.
Yes, we will. I promise you, before we leave the show, we will play your song.
Yes.
Oh, yes. But that was Miss Nastasia. That was called Mrs. Me Too. That was dope. I was actually
thank you.
Yes. So, Miss Rosemary Lopez, please go on to the reality check.
Reality check. All right. So, as you mentioned earlier, we know when us women, we know.
Just don't pay me no mind. I'm just in the zone.
Like
we know the minute before you even open your mouth to, like, you know, spit your game or whatever you're going to do, we know whether we're going to give you the number or not. Like, we know.
Yeah.
Already. We already made up our mind. Or sometimes some women, they like to wait till they hear them speak. You know, sometimes they're not sure. And sometimes they want to hear them speak before they actually
I don't think so. I think as soon as y'all see that brother walking, you're like, nope.
No, no.
As soon as they get here, I got a big fat
always,
no. You waiting for that no.
No, I'm saying that always, not always. Sometimes I do. Like me, sometimes like I want to hear.
That's you though.
What you speak like. No, but she's Miss Rainbow over there, not in your head, right?
You for real? You want to hear the dude talk?
Speak to, what they talk.
What about his swag? What if he's 350 pounds walking towards you?
Would you stop with the 350 pounds?
Yeah, what's with you with that?
I'm starting to tell you something.
Because a presentation is everything.
Fat boys are
I'm
more
sorry.
Welcome. They're welcome too. They need Look. Love too.
Teddy bear. We can't be. I wear this.
Not 300, okay? We're going to have to work out.
Chasing chubby women. Women chasing chubby men. Some women like men for protection.
That's not protection.
So
that's
the point
not
is,
protection.
We know already whether you're going to get the number or not, whether you're going to get the yes
okay,
or
okay.
not. Okay? So we can all agree on that. So what I want to hear from each and every one of you ladies is I need you to tell these men what not to do. For instance, I'm going to go first. There's one thing that I don't like when men do. Let's say, okay, you get passed and you get the number, which is rare. You know, you get the number. One thing, the first thing they go to is like, so what are your hobbies? What do you like to do besides? And I'm just like, for me, I don't like that. Like, that's the first
what are your
question
hobbies?
You're
they say
me.
That?
Yeah, like, what are your hobbies?
Come on,
like,
guys.
Yeah, like, they do
really,
that because they want to
know
what
are your hobbies?
Generic want, questions. Yeah.
Like, nah. That's the first question you're going to ask me.
Come
like, that's
on,
what
guys.
You want. Like, I don't know. To
say
me personally,
so.
That's just a turn. You know, like, that just to me
that sounds, isn't. Yeah, that sounds like a guy right? that doesn't know how to talk to girls.
Thank you. So, what do you like
He's
to do?
He's going off of, like, a
so,
script.
What do you.
Like, a list of questions.
What do you like to do besides. And I'm just like, what?
So, y'all listen. Go ahead,
All right, so that's one for me. All right, so you're next, yeah. Cynthia. What's something for you that's a don't, that's a do not do? What either it could be either once, like, them approaching you, it could be a part of an approach, like, do not do this, or it could be after the fact that they've already got your number or, you know, something, just do not do this.
One thing that I don't like is when we're out and it's at a, you know, somewhere where you're dancing and they ask you to dance and then they're trying to ask you all kinds of questions while you're dancing. I don't like that. I feel like let's dance.
Yeah. So where you from?
Enjoy. Yeah.
What you doing?
So where do you live?
You with your girls? Like,
what do you do for work? And you're
let
trying
me get
to-
your number.
Like dance first. I think that's a language in itself.
Right.
And then you can have a conversation after.
Yeah. Right.
It's really annoying when they're trying to do it during the dance. It ruins everything. You're like,
yeah,
you know what?
It's like, what are you doing? Cutting time?
Yeah.
Right.
I don't like
but
that.
You know
yeah.
why I do that? I give you some insight. This is why dudes do that. Because they feel like if after that dance is over, the chance is over.
Well,
period. If you walk away, there's 10 other dudes waiting to throw their pitch. They're waiting to get the end
of
the cut.
But she said yes
so
to dance with
the
you.
The dance is fine, but they know, okay, I got to close this deal fast because there's 10 other dudes over here that may have some on me that I don't have, so I need to
well,
hurry
okay,
up and get
why
this gun.
Then why can't
what
the dude
you,
just be like, why can't the dude just be like, hey,
they're
look.
They're campaigning. That's what we do.
Why can't the dude just be like, hey, look, once we're done with this dance, can you want to talk? I want to get to know you a little bit better.
Yeah.
No, because that's the, it, man, yeah.
No,
yeah.
If you dance I mean, good enough, she's not going to go anywhere.
But if she tells you to dance, then she's interested.
She's gonna stay.
Right.
That's true. That's a good
right.
point. That's
if you want to do all this talking,
that's a good point.
You
if
segue you, in, oh man, we've been dancing for a long time. You want to go get a drink with me?
Yeah, let's go get a drink. Yeah.
Thank you.
But see, dudes, man, nowadays, dudes like, y'all ain't about to buy no female no drink in the club, right, Bankhead? I mean, that's
what?
The rule.
What?
Don't buy, that's the rule. Am I right, Bankhead? Am I lying?
No, you don't
no,
do
no,
it.
No.
You don't do it to talk to her. You do it after.
No, but see, dudes, after their mentality already... is like this. I'm not about to buy this girl a drink because I don't know her from a can of paint. For one. And then for two, she gonna buy me a drink. That's the mentality of dudes.
That's
it's not
true.
Like
you awesome mentality.
Because females, when in a club, it's like they go to a club to get that kind of action. Okay, I want everything free. I got in for free. Girl, we about to drink for free. Look at this yup over here. Be chasing me all night. I'm
well,
about to
see,
have
I don't
all
know,
my drinks, me
like,
and my girls.
That's different for me. Like,
but that's
like,
how the club be.
You think so? Some
oh,
people
yeah.
just want to go and have a good time. Like, what do you mean?
Miss Nastasia, what is it? Give the fellas that are listening, fellas here, and the fellas that are listening back home, what is it do not do? What's a do not do? What's a one thing like you just don't like that males
one,
do? Like, in their approach or either when they're already there with
okay, you. So if you're dealing with me, one thing I can't stand is telling me that you're going to be somewhere or you're going to do something and then you don't do it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I don't care. Like, if you can't or unable to do
you mean like
whatever,
stand you up?
Yeah, stand
or,
me
or
up.
Not be a
or just
that
or,
is a definite
yeah,
no.
Being or just,
well, you
just,
gotta be specific about
even,
that.
Even like standing you up, or even like saying that you're gonna be somewhere, or if I'm waiting on you, like you get what I'm saying, like time management, like don't waste my time.
Be punctual.
Exactly. Not even that. Like, you could tell me that you're running late, but communicate.
But
like,
you gotta be specific
saying?
With that. Okay,
like,
so
communicate. Like, if something comes up or you can't do something or you can't make it, just let me know. Yeah. Don't have me waiting
now
for you.
Now, here's the perspective of that, okay? Are you employing this logic before or after he get the booty?
Both. What do you mean?
Because it's a difference.
There is no difference.
It's there's no difference.
Difference. What do you mean?
No, for real. If it's before...
What's the difference?
There's no difference.
How is it different?
How is that a difference?
If it's before...
There's no difference.
No, seriously. I'm being for real. This is mental logic. If it's before he gets the yum-yum, okay, he's going to be on time, okay? He ain't going to stand you up. And he's going to be punctual. If it's after... It's like flipping a coin.
What?
What do you think? He's not going to try as hard after?
Nah,
no,
because
they don't.
He already did his thing. See, I mean, this is reality.
And you wonder why we make you work so hard.
Mm-hmm. I feel you. And that's the...
Okay, I feel you.
Yeah. That's real talk. But that's real talk, though. I mean, because it's like that. You're going to get respect because men, I hate to say this, but I say this a couple other shows, like, we objectify women. Not we, but I'm just saying men in general. We look at y'all as objects, honestly. We don't really look at y'all as women. Because when we talk about y'all, we talk about y'all like, yeah, I just hit this...
This bitch.
What's that one dude? That one rapper? He's talking about I just did a three-peat, hit three girls, three whatever this week. Mm-hmm. See, we don't look at females as women or as like you are part of our league. Y'all in a totally different league. Y'all things of pleasure, objects of affection. You know what I'm saying? So for dude, y'all expect respect and all that. Like you said, Rain, like they gotta work for it.
They do. They should.
I feel you on that. No, it's real talk. Because dude's not gonna work for it. They're just not gonna.
I'm gonna personally know if a man's trying to treat me like an object. I'm gonna know by the way they talk to me, by the vibe
they
give
you.
To me,
and I.
Does she
now that you're talking, Miss Rain, what is one thing that do not do? Tell the men do not do.
Do not talk to me with your stank breath. You better have some good ass oral hygiene.
Foul. I'm sorry. I was talking to Doomy a couple of days ago. When did it become cool for women to have bad hygiene and have bad breath? I'm telling you, I'm running into females.
It's frightening.
I'm
brush
serious.
That's nasty.
I'm serious. I'm running into females. I'm having conversations. I'm like, oh.
Get your Gucci.
Damn. Like,
it's so bad.
This is not cool. Like, for real. Yeah. Bad hygiene. I go in for a hug. Oh, my God.
Nope.
Like, really?
Nope.
Really?
Why do you smell like rotten aloe vera? I need to
but
know.
But why is that cool? And we're going to get into
cool.
this with the double standard.
Maybe
why
she's
is that
unaware.
Come on.
You're not under. You,
a female
you
should
smell,
be aware
you know
of that.
How you smell.
I can say, but
no,
dude
just
is unaware.
People in general, some people don't know you they know. Have
females have no excuse. You can't be all stellated out with your out and your heels and all that looking all good, makeup
and,
done.
But
you smell like you just
smell.
Stepped out the damn farm. I mean, come on.
Yes.
Really? That don't even make sense. You took a bath in dirty water. Like, come on. What's up? I'm serious. I mean, that's not cool. Listeners, y'all need to get y'all a check, man,
because
I don't
because
know.
Because some of
that's
these,
like
people, some of
stuff,
these
huh?
people live out their car, too. So some of these girls
okay,
might look
okay, but they can afford
like
to get some Manolos and some
yes,
red bottoms.
Yes,
some people don't have their
that's
priorities
ignorant.
Straight. Right?
They don't.
Not only that, but here's the thing. Like a lot of people,
some
they're
people
used to their own scent. And so they don't think that they smell.
I'm used to cologne and bath water.
I know. You've seen those noseblind commercials.
Nah, you better get used to some perfume or some Paris Hilton or something.
But you
carry
know what?
But think about it.
But dudes don't care, man. They don't care what you
they
smell
don't.
Like.
They,
like,
they don't. They'll still, they will still do that.
Like, whatever.
Nasty. I will still
get your number.
I will still hit.
I'll still
even
exactly.
though your Gucci smells like old sewage water.
And they'll tell their boys, boy, that's real talk.
I don't know about all that.
No, they will. I'm telling
that's
you.
That's true. It's
I
true.
Yeah, I know some.
It's true. So, Cynthia,
not everybody's in here going like, dude.
I know.
Knowing each other.
I'm just saying, I got to put this out. I'm done with the time. I'm done with it. I'm going to say this and I'm done with it. Please, like, ladies, I mean, come on, man. Like, come on. I know dudes out here, they have bad breath. They smell like whatever. But that does not give you an excuse to do the same. It just doesn't. Because you're a female.
One of the advantages of being a female is that you smell good and taste good.
Yeah, exactly.
That's one of the advantages, goddammit. Shit.
We're supposed to smell and taste
like flowers.
You're
supposed to smell good. Yes, supposed to smell like flowers.
Eat pineapples, women.
Even when you fart, shit just smell like potpourri.
Does that pineapple thing
God
even
damn,
work?
She farted, that just smell
the pineapple?
Yes.
The pineapple thing work?
Oh, yeah. It makes you taste and smell bomb.
Oh,
for
word.
Sure. Mangoes,
now everyone's going to go buy some pineapple tomorrow. All the pineapples and syrup.
All the pineapples are going to be sold out tomorrow.
Stay away from cauliflower and broccoli and garlic and onion and fish sauce.
Okay. Damn, I like broccoli.
Oh, I love broccoli. makes you stink. Like a... And asparagus.
I love asparagus.
And fish.
I love asparagus.
Okay, real quick. Cynthia, please take us to the Daily Double real quick.
The Daily Double today, so we're opening up for the panel. We want to know, why is it okay, or why is it not okay, for a woman to approach a man, you know, showing interest, asking him out, but, you know, it's always like the job for the man to do, and that's okay. Because if a girl does it, it's she's aggressive, or she's desperate, or she's thirsty.
She's a stud.
Right? You know,
she's a stud.
But in reality, you know, it's okay for a woman to go up to a man and show interest, but
no,
I think it's frowned upon, because I don't know if it has to do
it's
with
not,
the man's ego.
It's not cool. It's not cool.
It's just an opportunity for a man to call her, like I said,
thirsty,
aggressive, right. She a hoe, whatever, because it's not normal.
I think
why is it frowned upon is what I want to know.
We'll start with Fly King Guy. Please grab the mic.
We got
Fly King Guy in the audience right now. Fly King Guy, please grab the mic real quick. Yes.
Hey. Wait, I'm supposed to answer.
What up, Fly King Guy?
Why is there a double standard in that?
I'm sorry, you have to run it back.
When a woman wants to approach a man with interest, and she wants to talk to him, ask him out, why is that frowned upon? Because I feel like women are looked at as thirsty or aggressive. Or desperate in that way when she does it, instead of letting the man do it first.
I think because it's just a man's place to, like, I think it's the same way, it's a stigma for a woman to propose to a man. It's just not in the court of public opinion something you do, especially in America. I think that's what it is. Just the culture of it is just not for it. Now,
not common.
I have an issue with a woman doing that? No, if that's what you've been trying to do your business. But it's just not what will be proper in American culture. You know?
I think it's cool if she look good. Like, if she's, like, butt ugly and she's 350 pounds, no. What up?
Why is everybody 350 pounds?
I don't know! What is that number?
All right, they're a little bit on the chunky side.
Then
no.
For real.
I think that it's even more rare if she's bomb looking. She doesn't need to upset anybody.
If she's bomb looking, and that's a psychology. If she's bomb looking, most likely, 9 times out of 10, she's not going to approach a dude.
Normally, an alpha female will be one to approach.
Yeah.
Yes.
She'll be like...
A beta and a sigma female, not so much.
No, alpha women, they too on their high horse. They think like men. Yeah, they too on their high horse. I don't think alpha woman would approach a dude.
No,
imagine Queen Latifah trying to go walk
up
to a dude. It's not happening.
Here's the thing, though, because alpha women, they know what they want, so they're aggressive. Like, this is what you said. They know what they want. Right? So
I can't imagine.
If I'm an alpha woman.
Hey, boo, you kind of cute. You should give me your number.
If I'm an alpha woman and I see something I like, I'm going to go for it.
It's not going to be trifling like that. It's going to be artistic. It's
going to
have some balls.
What is it going to say? What you going to say? You approach a dude. Tell me your pitch.
Yeah, what would you? Yeah.
What's your pitch?
I don't know what I would say. Honestly, I haven't approached a dude in a very long time, but it's something I have done
before. I know what you're probably going to say. You probably gonna say something like this because y'all are thinkers. So you probably gonna see a dude and you're gonna be like, okay, wow, you have a really nice smile. And he's gonna laugh like, yeah, wow, okay. So like if you're in a cafe or something, so what kind of coffee are you drinking? Now you come here a lot. You probably come at him like on some smooth tip, but you'll be sly with it. You'll compliment him.
Yeah, because
that's
course.
Usually what women do.
Well,
you have a pretty smile. They'll say that. And then here's what y'all do. No, I reverse. Okay, this is what y'all do. Y'all go to a dude and be like, okay, you have a nice smile. You have a pretty smile.
Oh,
and dude be like, oh, thank you. And then you'll just sit there and wait. You'll wait for him to say something back. Because right now, you kind of like throwing it at him. Like, look, bam, your turn.
I want you to wait.
And if he'll do not, you're like, this dude. You might even give him another shot. Do you come here often? you might look at him like crazy. And if he's still looking at this point, you feeling like, okay, let me go to the bathroom real quick because maybe something wrong with my makeup, something wrong with my hair. So let me go to the bathroom real quick. And then if you go to the bathroom and come back and he ain't there, you like, damn.
No. Honestly, if I'm going to approach a dude, I'm going for the kill because I already know that I got it.
So what you going to say to him?
No, I don't know what I would say. It's all improvised. It's all freestyled. If he's having some Jameson... I'm going to be, like, talking about the Jameson if he's wherever we're at.
I want to say, how do women approach dudes? How do women approach dudes? I just
want
to know.
You got to get what you want out of life.
How do women approach dudes?
I had a woman come up to me when I was in Ohio.
You just got to know you got it.
I had a woman come to me when I was in Ohio. Like, she came up to me like a dude. Like, yo, what's up? Like that.
No, that's not attractive. Like, not at least to me.
I gave her the wrong number. And she called it. She called it while I was standing in front of her. She called it. She's like,
no, did you make a run for it?
I'm too nice of a guy. I just stood there like.
And also, you know what? A lot of women don't do that because they're not used to it. They're not used to
rejection.
They're not used to the rejection. That's why a lot of people don't do that.
No, I was doing the day.
But you can't approach it like you're hitting on a dude. You got to approach it like this is somebody you're trying to make friends with, just somebody you're trying to have a conversation with. Like, you got to approach it like it's always the friend zone. Like, you just gotta be smooth. You gotta be confident.
And it helps when you're pretty. Like, when you're good looking, when you're pretty. Like,
yeah, but
helps,
if you're like, you know? Again, 350 pounds.
Oh my God.
And you're
butt ugly.
Make eye contact. I don't know. Just with the 350. But I'm just saying that. All right, if she's butt ugly, I'm just saying that. If she's butt ugly, she cannot approach a dude and expect this dude to.
But what
give
if the dude is ugly?
Yeah, that's a different story.
Yeah, that's what do you mean? If she's ugly,
what if he's ugly?
It's true. If
so,
why do you
think that ugly guys get like more prettier girls than
their personality alone, and they have money? When I say personality, I'm talking about their bank account, their car, and their money.
So what if a girl she has all of that? She's really swaggy.
And she ain't approaching no dude. She ain't approaching no dude.
Why?
Because she's just not. She feels like I'm the queen. I'm the ish.
But what if she does then? What do you think? What
if,
do you think
if a girl, I'm gonna think it's a transvestite.
Oh my god.
I'm gonna think it's a dude.
Really?
I am. I'm serious. I'm gonna think it's a dude. I am.
No.
Yo. I'm gonna think it's a dude. I'm like, okay,
that's something she likes and she's gonna go for it. That's all it is.
You're way too fine.
That's a very limited form of thinking.
I'm be like, what's a pretty night tonight?
Like, the way that this thinking is, like, I feel like this thinking's super limited. Like, we don't live in a generation where it's like 1950s, you know, Susie Homemaker. You gotta wait to be approached. You're the fucking flower waiting for the bee to come and land on you. Like, no, it's not like that anymore. We're dynamic beings and we have our own ideas and we could do whatever the hell we want. So a woman approaching a man with confidence, It's just gonna come out. It's natural.
I dig that.
It's not gonna be on a male dynamic. It's gonna be on a unique female dynamic.
I got you. I feel that. I'm not mad at that. But
let's get into your track real quick before we move on with life.
Yes. DJ Spin, you got that ready for Miss Rain.
Miss Rain, this dude.
Yes.
Damn.
Dopeness.
That's Miss Rain.
Damn. Dopeness, man.
Okay.
Y'all was listening to the sounds
wow,
of Rain.
Wow, like you. That's,
yeah.
That's amazing.
Yeah, yeah. She got that fire, yeah, man. Her vocals is
the voice
is
changes. Your voice changes.
I'm telling you, man.
Different notes.
She like Beyonce up in this piece.
She's
you know what I'm saying?
Mariah Carey up in here.
Yeah, man.
right?
Hold on, you got some voice on that.
Wait a minute.
This nigga got a voice.
It's not about me.
That was kind of on. That was kind of on pitch. Usually when people can't sing, they off pitch. Yo, you was on pitch.
I think Miss Rain inspired
you. You inspired me to sing. It just comes out.
Yes. Okay, yeah, so right now we're about to get into my segment. Let's be real. I got to do that to the music. Come on.
You can't sing like that. You sure it's not called Let's Be 350
Pounds? Yes.
Right, exactly.
It is.
I'm not sure.
Fly King Eye in the building, y'all.
Yes.
This man right here. This is a segment when I, Unique Akeem, state 7 things from a unique perspective that I feel are relevant to the topic in discussion. All those that agree, say real talk. And all those that think I'm bullshit and just be like, yo, that's some bullshit. Which I know all y'all ladies out here gonna probably say. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, perspective number one. Alpha women only date alpha men because beta and sigma men she would consider weak and incapable of handling her.
Bullshit.
No, that's real talk.
Bullshit.
No, bullshit.
An alpha woman cannot date an alpha man. Like,
opposites attract.
I can close my case in two words.
Exactly.
Okay. Queen Latifah, have you ever seen her with a dude?
She likes women.
No, you can't have two strong-minded people like that in one relationship.
No, you can't.
That's why.
They will bump heads.
That's why.
Right? You ain't see Set It Off?
No, she do like women, but I'm just saying, like, those type of women are like alpha women. Seriously.
You can't have an alpha woman.
Isn't Oprah considered to be an alpha woman?
Alpha, yes, she is.
She got a man.
That's questionable.
But the thing is he an alpha
man?
That's
very questionable.
No, he's not.
Exactly.
She's
in charge. Exactly. Exactly. An alpha man and an alpha woman.
No, yeah, sure, right.
You walking the dog.
Right.
He's doing everything she's telling him.
Okay, so. Oh, that's different. That's way different. Because Jay-Z's an alpha male and Beyonce's an alpha woman. So right. I mean, you can't. That's the same thing. So you agreeing with me, huh? Huh? Yes, real talk.
Thank you.
Yes. See, you just messed up. Okay. All right, mistake number two. If an unattractive woman throws game at a man, he is most likely going to say he has a girlfriend or he's married. If a 350-pound, if a 350-pound woman approach a dude, he's going to say he's married or he got a girlfriend. That real talk or BS?
I mean, I guess if he's trying to preserve her feelings.
I call that real talk.
Yeah. I've done it. I'm married. I got a girl.
Where's your ring at?
I agree. I feel like I lost it in the dryer.
Because we do that. We do that, though. I'd be like, I have a boyfriend real quick. You know what? I'll be going home to Ted every
real
night.
Real talk.
I have a personal teddy bear.
But in the window, y'all don't know about that. Okay, so, percent number three. A beta woman would forgive her man for cheating, but alpha woman would not only leave her man, but call the girl he cheated on her with and threaten to kick her ass. Alpha woman, yes.
I don't agree
alpha
with
woman,
that.
Black. She said it. Yes, she would. Man, please. I've been through it.
I'm going to say real talk.
You've been dating my, Maurice's
girlfriend. But why would she even, why? If she left him already, why would she have to deal with
it's
the
a,
woman
It's a territorial
on the
type thing.
It's
territory.
Yeah. I don't know.
Alpha women.
They wear like that. They think like dudes.
Well, yeah, you wouldn't think that because you're not, you don't consider yourself an alpha woman. So, like, me either. So, me, that doesn't make sense either. Yeah. But to an alpha female, that those are the kinds of things she would do.
See, a dude's not gonna care.
Make sense to her.
Yeah. A dude's not gonna care. If he catches girl cheating on a dude, he ain't gonna care. I mean, he gonna care. He gonna check her about it, but he ain't gonna go check the dude because it's like, what you opening your legs for this dude? Why should I get on this dude? He's just being a man. You know what I'm saying? Like, you with me. Like, what the hell are you doing? Like, that's how.
For all I know, you could
have
told me.
Exactly.
You could have.
You could have told me. Exactly. But then you do got some dudes out there that be on that square shit, though. I can't even say that. They be like, I'm about to, we're here. You know what I'm saying? So. Anyway, spectrum number four. Females already know before a man opens his mouth if they are going to accept
real
or
talk.
Decline his
real
game.
Talk.
That's real talk.
Real talk.
Yes.
A 350 pound.
Oh my God.
Listen, if we had any 350 pound listeners, we don't anymore.
Okay, I'll say 190
pounds.
Right? Yeah, we don't anymore. They're like, oh, okay.
Okay, yeah, so yeah, that's most likely going
to
happen.
I used to like him. Not anymore.
before.
But why y'all decline dudes before they even approach y'all? I mean, it's not fair.
Why isn't it fair? The same way that you're going to decline an ugly chick when she walks up to you the same way.
Let me ask y'all a question.
No, but see, guys are actually different. Y'all will see what she's going to like to offer, and then y'all decline.
Correct.
But let me ask y'all a question. Why y'all give dudes the eye? Why y'all give him the eye? Y'all look at him kind of weird, give him the eye like, okay, it's okay to approach, and then the dude approaching, y'all shoot him down.
No, I just looked at him. I probably looked past him, and y'all think that I looked at you. Like, I can't. I don't understand why I can't look straight or look at you and then that means, hey, come talk to me. Right. Like, no.
But y'all be knowing what y'all be doing.
No, because I was at the pool. I was at the pool the other day, minding my business.
You was at the pool dressed like what?
I was at the pool. What do you mean? I had on a bathing suit. What are you supposed to wear at the pool? A jacket and scarf and gloves?
No, but you at the pool with your two-piece and you just so happened to look at a dude.
No, I was minding my business and he so happened to come over to talk about nonsense and clearly I don't want to talk to you.
So you make no eye contact with
him. I want to tan and you're blocking my sun. Like, come on, dude. Like, and he started talking about the most randomest stuff.
Was he 350 pounds?
He looked dirty. That's what he looked like. But regardless of the case, it's just like, it's just like, I feel like guys expect you, like, you have to talk to them. Like, I don't have to talk to you. Because if I was, like, some old white lady down the street and then she walked past you, she doesn't have to speak to you. You're not going to sit there and, like, hey, how are you? How you doing?
You probably give her a heart attack.
No, you're going to mind your business and keep it moving. You're not going to harass her.
There's a time and a place for everything, too.
Yes.
And you know why also? It's because a lot of men, when they approach you, like, automatically, and I know it might not always be the case, and it might not be right, but automatically you're like, oh, here he comes with the BS. Like,
exactly.
You know what I mean?
Like, if he's a player.
You know, like, a lot of men just come with the BS. Like, when you meet somebody, you don't meet them, you meet the representative. So it's like, it's not really you I'm meeting. You're just spitting game. You're getting at me the way you want me to.
Baby, let me take you out.
I'm glad you said that. This alludes me to the next perspective. Females claim they hate dating players, but will date them anyway because of the excitement and drama that comes with them. Sometimes a woman just wants to enjoy the game. That's true.
Facts.
That's facts.
That's facts.
Yeah. Thank you.
Because that's facts.
That's real talk.
Because I'd be like, I don't like him. He's getting on my nerves. But then he'll call.
But they still messing with him.
And then I'll still go. And then the next day I'll be mad. And then he'll call me back. And I'll be like, okay,
this will trip me out. Dude could be on the phone with you. Dude could be on the phone with you. Be like, yo, what's up? And then you be like, hey, what's going on? Hold on 1 second. I got another call coming in. Click back over. Hey, what's up? Yo, I got this girl on another line. Let me call you back. Click. And y'all be like, hey, this a motherfucker. Then he call you back. Yo, what's up? I'm about to come over. Okay.
Yeah. That's true.
Because it's like a turn on the fact that other women want him.
Yeah.
It's not,
real
not even that. Like, I don't know.
Like, Cynthia, like,
especially with me. Like, I don't like losing. I might not even show interest, like, really have interest in you, but just because, like,
it's exciting.
Just the fact that someone else has attention.
I'm petty.
Just the fact that someone else has attention, you're like, oh, hell no.
And you may not even take the dude seriously, but it's just the fact that he's fun.
Yeah.
You know, you just like the whole, you know, that he's a player.
Just to have an argument. Just to argue with somebody. Like, you didn't call me back. I really don't care, but you still didn't call me back.
I don't understand, y'all. That's the part of it I don't understand.
I don't understand it.
No, I understand it. I can break that down in a minute. Okay, so, perspective number six. Men should never overcompliment a woman because it makes them look weak and desperate. I think that's true.
Men should never overcompliment a woman because...
Yes, brain. If a man comes up to you and just, I love your hair, I love your face, I love your jeans, I love your bracelet, I love your hair, I love
your
eyes.
But some women might like all that.
I'm just going to look at you like, you don't know me. Like, I'm just like,
But it's overly doing it. You look weak.
I don't know. I feel like there's many ways to look weak. And
that's one of them.
Some girls really, really enjoy compliments. That's their love language.
Ain't nobody trying to.
Some girls do.
Ain't no female trying to.
I think he'll just resort to that because he's seeing that he's losing it. Like, she's going, she's not interested, so I'm gonna keep complimenting her because that's the only way I'll keep her there.
Yes.
Yeah, but you know what? Over complimenting though,
it's annoying. Number seven. Females are very emotional creatures. To truly conquer her, you must interest her mind. People, once you have gained her interest, her consideration for you will then become available, and the time spent with her will cause her to emotionally unravel to your advantage or disadvantage. This real talk, man.
Yeah, that's real.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? I put out I shouldn't have did that, but that's real talk. Yeah. That's real talk, though. Okay, so real quick, to conclude, this the whole thing. All right, I'm gonna tell y'all a little something about y'all females, and this is some real talk. Okay, so
break it down.
Remember this.
Give us a solution.
Experience is life's greatest teacher, okay? Right. So whatever you experience dealing with dudes, those are lessons learned that you adapt as being law, literally. So any relationship you get into after that, it's going to be a problem. For instance, you take a woman that's with an abusive dude and he's doing this and doing that to her. When she get with a dude, good dude, she appreciates the fact that he's a good dude, but she don't know how to be with that dude. Hence, that if that man is not doing some of the same things that that man was doing in her previous relationship, she's going to feel like something is missing. You see what I'm saying? So back to Nastasia's thing, what she said earlier about why they like to argue and all this is because that's what they're used to. That's, you know what I'm saying? That's what it is.
What life, they know.
Experience is life's greatest teacher. You take a woman that come from church and she been with a good dude all her life, she ain't gonna know how to act with a bad boy. You know what I'm saying? So that's the reality of what it is. So in conclusion, this is what it is. How to talk to women straight up, it's different. You know what I'm saying? It's different for everybody. It's different types of women. Main thing is don't say nothing stupid. Don't offend her. You know what I'm saying? And make sure you come with some type of conversation. That's really what it is. You know what I'm saying? Interest or interest. Get a mind right. You know what I'm saying? You might get to square two if you're lucky. I don't know. So anyway... Fly King guys in the building. Fly King, please grab the mic.
I'm on the mic.
You're on the mic. Damn, my bad. See, I'm all gone.
You can't see me behind this TV.
I can't see you, man. I can't see you. Yeah, so LA Battlegrounds, this dude right here is the dopest battle rapper in LA to me, if you ask me. This dude is sick.
Thank you.
Dude is sick. I'm serious. Like, I've seen him. He slaughters cats. He's so bad that he wasn't even battling, right? And he's on the sideline, and the people that's battling the other dude is attacking him. He on the sideline.
That's very true.
I'm like, what the dude, the dude is in the ring. Why are you attacking him? He's over there eating Cheeto. You know what I'm saying? So, Fly King guy, what's going on with you? Please let him know where they can find a battle rap real quick.
Well, you can go on my website to get everything Fly King at flykingeye.com. But I have a crazy battle coming up this Saturday. It's me versus another artist named Perfecto. It was really crazy. You was there for
that. You slayed him, dog.
I slayed him. Oh, you heard that, Perfecto? I didn't say that. They said it. So y'all got to check that out. That's going to be April 16th this Saturday. And you'll check that out on bzfilms.com with a Z.
B-Z-F-I-L-M-Z.
Z.
Is that a pay-per-view event?
That's going to be a pay-per-view event. Okay. So that makes me one of the first to have one of those on LA Battleground.
That out,
so I'm very excited about that.
I'm going to post that on my social media and all that so y'all can check them out. You know what I'm saying? We're going to make sure we approach that real good. Why don't you spit something real quick before we get out of here, Mr. Fly King guy, real quick.
Let me know what something.
That, please spit something, yo, because your fire. Spit that one joint when you talking about the Maserati.
I like ace of spades in the glass because the boy likes swish. Pull up the 76, fill up the 6-on-6. Premium propane is unleaded. You sourdough jack clowns, you unbreaded. Been doing this since niggas was hanging with Mr. Cooper. Might pull a Cooper. Bombs bigger than Mini Coopers. A big gun with bullets the size of Oompa Loompas. Causing thunder and lightning. Yeah, we stormtroopers. And you rap niggas is going to have to do better. Me, Kim, Caitlin, and Chris Jenner at the Beverly Center. Hey. I'm on my Dej Loaf. If a nigga want to try it, address me as the Fly King. I private, the Fly King I and VIP somewhere private. I steps up the lid before I wave to the pilot. The reality show was good.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Hey, low key, you spit that same rhyme last time, but it's cool though. We still
half of it. Don't do me.
I hear the last part. That's cool though. Yes. So it's the reality show. People, tune in next week. Topic gonna be independent women.
Wait a minute.
Oh yeah.
Wait a minute. Where can we find you, Nastasia?
Nastasia, yes.
Online. Where can we find you?
You can find me at Nastasia Smith on everything: Periscope, Twitter, SoundCloud, Instagram, Facebook. That's Nastasia.
Yeah, y'all go check out that new joint she got too, man. That's on SoundCloud, right?
Yes, it's on my SoundCloud. I am gonna be putting it on iTunes soon, so be available for purchase. So.
Dopeness, Miss Rain. Can they find you at?
What's good? RainBizou, RainBizou.com. You can also find me on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and whatever other social media you can find. Just Google me.
Yeah, she's
my
that famous.
My EP's Lucid Dreams. Peep it. It's dope as fuck.
I'm bumping that in my car right now. Yes. And Cynthia, where can they find you at? Beautiful, lovely Cynthia Garcia. With the bounty for hair. Go ahead.
I'm on Instagram at Cinnabon, CYN_ABUN.
Cinnabon. Miss Rosemary Lopez, where can I get you?
Miss Rosemary Lopez, MS Rosemary Lopez.
Yes, and I'm Miss Unique King. You can catch me on Instagram, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And also on Facebook. Deuces.